Guys, today we're going to craft this wonderful and beautiful Lobelia winteriana. I've just got this plant. It wasn't really cheap, but it's super healthy. It looks very hydrated, and it already has a flower bud, you know. And I thought about leaving it like this, but I want to graft it on Trichoceros because this is a very, very nice Lobelia winteriana clone. It has some of the most beautiful flowers I've seen on a Lobelia winteriana so far. And yeah, I will use the stump to harvest pups. And yeah, we'll graft this on a strong growing, fast growing grafting stock. So I just wanted to show you this plant, how it looks like before we cut it. And I'll make a cut now at the lower base. I try to leave just as much as I need to keep the stump alive, you know. I want the stump to survive, and since this one is so well hydrated, I don't think it will be a problem. So I'll show you the grafting stock that we'll use. This here's my co-worker that's helping me in my effort, and yeah, this is the ugly plant that I will graft on. It's totally crooked, and has a few problems, you know. You can see here. I thought about leaving the plant just for flowering and for crossing, but you know, there's no way this is going to look nice again. This here is a sunburn that it got a few months ago, and yeah, I'll just use the base for grafting, and use the rest to take cuttings. This plant will probably be big enough to give me at least 10 different cuts that I can root separately and to graft on, you know. So yeah, let's start. So I've put the plant against something to stabilize it, just because it's very shaky. If I'd leave it alone, I'd need a stick or something to straighten it out, and it would take a good couple years until it's straight again. And again, it's not the only one that I have of this clone, and I need some grafting stocks more than I need another Trichoceros paranoi. All right, so now we'll cut it. We'll cut it around here. That leaves a good healthy base, and we have at least 40-50 centimeters of growth that we can use for taking cuttings. So I'll get a knife. I have a bread knife, a very sharp bread knife. I've cut myself a few times before with it. Snoopy, careful, it's dangerous. So I'll cut it here. I want to leave a little bit. Core, the vascular bundle is so thick, I barely get it through. And the spines don't really help. You know, I don't want to break it, because when you're breaking something, there's a higher chance for infection. I think I need to put it sideways a little bit. Yeah, should have done this right away. So now this is the plant that we cut, and I will take a few cuttings of this one. So I'll make a cut here, one here, one here, and so on. These can be rooted separately, and they will be perfect grafting stocks in the next season. I'm doing this now because I want them to develop some roots before the winter. So, all right, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. And this here, this is the base, and this is going to be our grafting stock. So I'm straightening this out a little bit So. And I'm removing the edges because I don't want this guy to push off my grafting stock, my scion, my graft. Cutting away the edges helps to reduce the pups that come out from the base. They have a hard time growing on scar tissue, you know? All right. So, it's not straight, but it's straight enough. Ow. So, now I'll get the graft. If I find it again. Oh, yeah. So, I think this should be enough. So, this is the size of the graft. This here is the size of the base. It's barely enough to survive on its own, but it will do just fine. When you graft, you need to make sure that the vascular bundle in the center overlaps with the vascular bundle of the grafting stock, and that's really important. So I'll put it just here. It's perfect for this stock, and I'm pretty sure that the flower bud will eventually develop. So it's unlikely that it would stop flowering now that I've cut it, you know. I thought about it a little bit, but then I was sure that it will flower nonetheless. So yeah, now we need to put pressure on the graft, and yeah, and that's almost it. So let me just get something to put a little bit of pressure on the scion, and I will use rubber bands and painter's tape. So I have these rubber bands, but I will use the painter's tape first because it helps to keep the graft in place where it belongs, you know. These move very easily, and it's important that the graft stays exactly where it is, otherwise you are at risk of missing the vascular bundle. So with lots of pressure, a little bit, yeah, that was nothing, that was bad. All right, this is it. This is good. Oh. So, okay, now I have it. Painter's tape is perfect for grafting. It's just, you know, it has the right. You get it off easily when you're done. And it has enough strength to put a lot of pressure on your graft. It's perfect. Since I'm using painter's tape, my success rate has increased dramatically. So, neighbors are building something. All right, so now I'll put some additional rubber bands around it, but they are mostly just to secure the tape. The painter's tape is already enough. And yeah, this is my graft of Lubivia winteriana. I will leave it like this for a week, and then I'll put it into the sun because I want it to start growing right away. And yeah. This is pretty much it. It's not rocket science. You can do it very easily. You just need a very healthy and well hydrated grafting stock, and it's best if your graft is very very hydrated too. Okay, guys. So I'll keep you updated how it goes with my graft. Pretty sure it will grow just fine. Take care. Bye.